Hi, I'm your host Vasco Duarte. Welcome to the Scrum Master Toolbox podcast, where we share tips and tricks from Scrum Masters around the world. Every day, we bring you inspiring answers to important questions that all Scrum Masters face day after day. On Fridays, we talk about the product owner role in Scrum. We talk about patterns and anti-patterns that relate to ours and the team's collaboration with the product owner. And we've also put together a course to help you navigate that relationship. There's 18 modules, nearly 8 hours of tools, techniques, videos, handouts, presentations you can use to help you and your team work better with your product owner. The course is available at bit.ly/coachyourPO. All lowercase, all one word, that's bit.ly/coachyourPO. And now, on to the show, the Product Owner Show. Hello, everybody. Welcome to our PO, the TGIF episode, as they say, with Stefania Marinelli. Hi, Stefania. Welcome back.
Hi, Vasco. Hi, all.
So, Stefania, we talk about product owners today, and we'll start with a bad example so we can end up on a high and talk about a good example later. But share with us what might have been the most significant product owner anti-pattern that you've witnessed in your career.
Yes, thank you, Vasco. So I start thinking about all the product owner I worked with, and I think I was quite lucky because the product owner I were working with was a quite good product owner. I think that the anti-pattern I found was few. So one is the technical product owner, a person that maybe was a developer and is still very interested in technical stuff. He or she is asking for technical detail, why you are doing that instead of those. And sometimes I came up asking he or she if he want to help the team develop the feature, since she's very interesting into technical details. But yeah, the technical product owner is maybe the most common in my experience. Another one was new day, new priority. So we did the planning, the product owner reviewed the commitment. Yes, all is good. The team started working, and then the second day of the sprint, no. hold on, there is a new priority. And obviously, if this it happen only once, it's okay. It can be, but if you have new priority every day, yes, could be a problem. Another problem was a product owner that is available only during the planning meeting, and then not available during the sprint because he was too busy to answer to any doubts or question that the team can have, because you have to work with stakeholders or following the business priority or whatever it is, but we can see him only during the planning, so not so useful. And I think the one that it's really hard for me is a product owner that is not the owner of the project. So like a proxy product owner or someone that is not able to take the ownership of the product. So he have to ask other people to reply to the team, or cannot give to the team the answer about the value, the feature they are developing. Yes, I think that they are quite good example. Vasco, what do you think?
Absolutely. There's actually quite a lot of examples in that answer. I'm sure many have felt some of those, if not many of those. There is one, though, that I wanted to explore a little bit more. So I did the product owner e-course, which is available for people who listen to the podcast. Just go to the link that is on the show notes. But one of the questions that I got asked when I was preparing that course is, you know, what to do if the product owner is really just a proxy and isn't able to make decisions. So the not empowered product owner. And that was one of those that you mentioned. So I'm really curious to understand what you did when working with such a product owner to try to, of course, mitigate the problem, but actually to help the product owner and the team do a better job.
I think that here there are two different problems. So if the product owner is maybe a new one and she or he cannot take decision, it's a matter of time so that after some months she can be more aware of the different stakeholder understanding and reply to the team. The other problem that is a bigger one is that you are not able to take decision because also in product you have a lot of dependency between different products that the same company is developing. So you have to wait for other to take this decision. So in this case, what I did usually is to, if it's possible, to bring to the team the right people, so to do something all together. If the product owner doesn't have the right answer, who is the person that can give to the team the right answer, bring him or her to the team. If it's not possible, another thing is working with the different stream of product, understanding how, as a Scrum Master, can help them managing these dependencies and give clarity on priority so that the product owner can be really the product owner of the product.
Absolutely. That's actually one of the answers that I gave in that e-course module, which is to bring people together that need to make the decision and actually then develop that ability, you know, to know where are the decision lines, right? So because the product owner proxy needs to learn what type of decisions he or she is allowed to make.
Exactly. So happy I gave the right answer, Vasco.
Well, there's many answers and yours wasn't exactly the same. And that's why I like to do this podcast, because I learn new things every time somebody gives an answer to something I've thought about and they have a different perspective. I learn new things all the time. So that's brilliant. We need to have, as the name of the podcast goes, we need to have a lot of tools in our toolbox.
Exactly. Yes.
So, Stefania, now we turn our attention to the good product owner. So share with us what might have been the best product owner and the pattern that you've seen in your career.
So I am thinking about a very good product owner I've been working with. So I really like where the fact that she took notes during the daily, for example. And she took notes because during the day, she was working on the bloggers, obviously the bloggers related to products that the team share with her during the daily, or working on questions that the team asked during the daily. So she was not only there to listen, but to actually understand how she can unblock the team, if she can. Another good habit was asking very good question to the team. So open question to understand better the complexity of the work. And when I say complexity, I'm not saying that she was asking how many hours, days, points or whatever, but she want to understand why this piece is so complex, to be able also maybe to explain back to her manager, I don't know, but she wants to understand the why, also to be, I think, yes, to be closer to the team, to understand what the technical difficulty is, not to solve, not to suggest, only to understand. Another good pattern here was focus on business value. So to have a clear priority for the story, not to change priority after the sprint, for example, and to share with the team the result. Not so many product owners I've been working with are sharing the result with the team. So at the end of the quarter or at the end of the project, sharing the result, sharing the earning with the team. So we developed this and then we are earning that thanks to your job, thanks to the feature that you developed. And this was so helpful for the team. This gave to the team the passion, the visibility of the work, understanding the value they are bringing to the company. So it was also a link from the feature to, let's say, to the mission of the team, to the mission of the company. We are working on this feature and we are seeing the result. So very, very useful.
I find that aspect of motivating, creating the vision, the understanding, but also the passion. I think that aspect of motivating is one of those that I really like when working with product owners, because it makes the work of the Scrum Master so much easier. Right. So we don't need to worry about the team not wanting to do something. They already want to do it. We just need to get some of the obstacles out of the way. And as of course, some of the obstacles, the PO will take him or herself. So I really like that. And I think that's probably one of the most important aspects when it comes to being and to becoming a great product owner.
Yes. And also, if you are doing this work, you don't have as PO time to think about technical decision or implementation. So your focus is there, is for understanding the business value, sharing the result with the team and stakeholder, understanding if you are working on the most valuable thing linked to your vision and mission. So you don't have time to do the anti-pattern that we talked about before.
Absolutely. Stefania, that was a great episode. Thank you very much for sharing all of those stories with us. We're close to the end, though, but before we do go, do share with us. Where can we find out more about you and the work that you're doing?
So I am on LinkedIn, so you can find me only writing down my name, Stefania Marinelli. And I think that's it. I'm not so social person, but when I have something to share, LinkedIn is the social that I'm using.
Absolutely. We'll put the link on the show notes so that all of you can easily get in touch with Stefania. Stefania, thank you very much for sharing all of this with us, for your generosity with your time and your knowledge.
Thank you so much, Vasco, for having me, for inviting me. It was a pleasure.
One more week of the Scrum Master Toolbox podcast is over, but there's a lot more we have to share. We have developed our own membership site where you find a community of active and engaged Scrum Masters. In this site, you get access to exclusive content and get to interact with us, your podcast hosts, as well as the best Scrum Masters in the world. join us at scrummastertoolbox.com/podcast and keep this podcast free of advertising. See you next week for one more week full of Scrum Master tips and tricks.
We really hope you liked our show. And if you did, why not rate this podcast on Stitcher or iTunes? Share this podcast and let other Scrum Masters know about this valuable resource for their work. Remember that sharing is caring.